So if you're a OnePlus fan or planning to buy a OnePlus phone, well, stop right there. 2021 is probably not the best time to buy OnePlus devices. And before we get to the video, if you're a OnePlus fan like I am, dude, it's heartbreaking. I would suggest don't go ahead, skip the video. Now with that out, what's wrong with OnePlus in 2021? I wouldn't recommend you to buy the latest OnePlus devices. You know why? Well, for that, let's look at the product releases of OnePlus in 2021 up until now. In January 2021, we had the OnePlus brand launch for 2,500. And then you had the major OnePlus launch event in March 2021. There were four devices that were launched: OnePlus 9R, OnePlus 9, OnePlus 9 Pro, and the OnePlus Watch. Let's head back to January and start with the OnePlus brand first. It's a successful product and a lot of people bought it. Like even now, if you go to Amazon, it's an Amazon choice. So a lot more people are going to buy it. Now, there are a lot of problems with OnePlus Band and it's nowhere close to Mi Band 5 or even Honor Band 5. But leaving all that aside, I'll pick up two major issues that are worth pointing out and a real deal breaker. First, sleep tracking. The sleep tracking on OnePlus Band isn't accurate. It's the most basic thing you buy a fitness tracker for, and it would have been fine if the OnePlus Band was released 2 to 3 years ago. But now, the sleep data isn't on par with other bands. And we waited for a few updates as well. Even after those updates, the situation hasn't improved. Second, the OnePlus Health mobile app itself. Even if you ignore the bad Play Store ratings, the app is half-baked, with a lot of features missing that you can find in other fitness band apps. Now, I won't go into the details for that. You can check out our OnePlus Band review, but in short, the OnePlus Band was released for the sake of releasing it. And it doesn't even have an edge over Honor Band 5 or Mi Band 5, even though it cost just as much as those bands. Let's move on to the major OnePlus March launch event. Let's take OnePlus 9. For starters, as you might already know, there is a difference between OnePlus 9 sold in the US versus the OnePlus 9 sold in India. The Indian OnePlus 9 has only two 5G bands and the US one gets God knows 20 plus. Anyways, as per OnePlus customer representative, OnePlus 9 will be updated with more 5G bands in the future. We'll definitely keep an eye on that. And anyways, if you let 5G go and say, come on Pratik, 5G is still not there, you made a video on it. Well, the Indian variant of OnePlus 9 doesn't have 15 watt Qi wireless charging and the US version has it. Meaning, basically, if you don't buy a OnePlus wireless charger, you cannot wirelessly charge with any other wireless charger in the market or at your home. But okay, let's keep all that aside. Every brand has few nitpicking here and there. Let's not go down that road. What bothers me as a OnePlus fan is that OnePlus has a long history of claiming to be a small innovative startup who often doesn't spend money on impractical things. Like OnePlus didn't go for IP68 water and dust certification because it costs extra money. But now they went out and spent $169 million on a 3-year Hasselblad branding, which is effectively, as of now, just optimization and colors to the camera. Basically, it's just a filter on your photo as of now. Moving on to the OnePlus 9 Pro. OnePlus 9 Pro is itself a good device, but there are two problems. One, the pricing. The pricing jump from OnePlus 7T Pro to OnePlus 8 Pro to OnePlus 9 Pro is massive. In just 3 years, the pricing of OnePlus flagship saw a jump of almost 20,000. That's something for a once upon a time flagship killer. Second, OnePlus 9. It's not bad, but it's so compromised and it is priced in such a way that you're pushing 9 buyers to buy 9 Pro rather than keeping it as a premium offering. So if you're there to buy OnePlus 9, you might get compelled to buy the OnePlus 9 Pro instead. Like, the OnePlus 9 doesn't have OIS. Like, even the OnePlus Nord has OIS. So you get the OnePlus 9 Pro for that. Now, you might say, Pratik, there's also a cheaper OnePlus 9R. How about that? It was released exclusively in India. But you know what? The 9R doesn't exist. It's basically previous year OnePlus 8T rebranded as OnePlus 9R. This rebranding thing is an industry standard in India, but didn't expect that from OnePlus. There's no reason to have OnePlus 9R when we already have the OnePlus 8T selling in the market. Now, finally, OnePlus Watch. I think this is the most disappointing OnePlus release ever. If you see the global coverage, this is the story. Thanks to TechAlter for the tweet. But leaving all that aside, I personally see three things that OnePlus could have done to improve the OnePlus Watch. First, there's no reply to notifications in OnePlus Watch. If you're calling it a smartwatch, then it needs to have reply to notification, else it's no difference from tons of cheap fitness band mirroring messages. Second, the OnePlus Watch is only available in 46mm, while the usual watch size is 38, 41, and max it goes to 44mm. To give you a perspective, if you translate 46mm into clothes, it's double XL. So if you're a girl or an average height dude like 5'10, 46mm is too big for you. So who is it for anyways? Last, it doesn't have Wear OS, so no apps, nothing. Is it even a smartwatch? Overall, for the same features, you can get the Oppo Watch. By the way, video coming up real soon, and now is a good time to hit the bell icon and subscribe. So to sum it up, I understand it's business by the end of the day. Every company wants to get big, make more money, get mainstream, make more profit, but it hurts as an enthusiast to see it, like a breakup. I wish OnePlus good luck, and I'm somewhere down the line happy as well that it's getting mainstream, but sad at the same time that I won't talk about it with the same excitement. So overall, this year 2021 so far, there is little innovation from OnePlus, be it your fitness band, watch, or even phone, but pure marketing and banking on their old reputation, which they build over the years. So if you're someone looking to buy OnePlus in 2021 solely based on their old brand image, well, hopefully this video showed you a different perspective. And remember, you buy a product and not the company. With that said, share this video with your friends who might be thinking of buying OnePlus stuff. It's Prateek, you're watching TechWiser. See you soon.